New at 6, a Beaver Creek reservist who witnessed a mass killing comes home. But as Pam Elliott shows us, this Army colonel actually faced tragedy on three fronts.
This is something that I will never take off. This was our finest tribute, and we carry them with us.
U.S. Army Reserve psychologist Colonel Kathy Bottoni wears a bracelet with the names of five fallen comrades who, like her, dedicated their lives to helping troops cope with the tragedies of war.
It's as if you put everything aside, you go on automatic pilot, kind of like a gun run, and just do what has to be done.
Bottoni was at Fort Hood, Texas a year ago when authorities say Major Nadel Hassan killed 13 people and wounded 30 others.
They were always kind of on edge, always kind of looking at the doorway to see what's coming in.
And more so because of what happened.
Exactly because of what's happened.
Her unit, the 467th Combat Stress Control Detachment, went on to Afghanistan a month after the shootings.
We were each given the choice not to deploy, but the bonds that we had were so strong, and we were interwoven so tightly that we decided the finest tribute to our fallen comrades was to go forward, perform the mission, and do our unit proud, and we did just that.
It was Colonel Bottoni's fourth deployment. She recently came home to her husband to face not only the losses within her military family, but the deaths of her mother and her two dogs.
No disrespect, Colonel, but do you feel in any way the Army failed to protect you at Fort Hood?
I think this was an issue of someone who had serious issues and extremist views. And I think that had everything to do with it. I don't think the Army or anyone could be equipped to prevent something like this from happening, although with the lessons learned, hopefully we will be able to do that better in the future.
Colonel Bottoni says she can't go into great detail about what happened last November 5th because the case has yet to go to trial. But she says it helps her to talk about the incident as much as possible. Talking and writing are the two ways she helps herself move forward after such tragedies. Pam Elliott, 2 News on your side.